Hello friend, welcome to Marine Engineering Hub. This is your author Ravi Gupta. Today we are going to talk about tie bolt. This is a very important topic which has been asked in MEO class 2 and MEO class 4. I will try to cover from base to advanced level. Please watch it. It will be provided in 3 or 4 series tie bolt. And before watching the tie bolt, please also watch the video of interbleacher, A-frame and bed plate, as it will give you a better idea about the tie bolt. Okay, so let's begin the video. What is tie bolt and why it is fitted? So tie bolt is provided to hold the entablature, A-frame and bed plate together in compression as a rigid structure. So what do I mean by that? As you can see, this is the entablature which form the part of the scabbing space and the cylinder housing. This is the A-frame where the connecting rod and crosshead guide is provided, and this is the bed plate which accommodate main bearing and also the crankshaft housing part. Now this three component is been held in together in compression with the help of this tie bolt. Means this tie bolt is holding the bed plate, A-frame and entablature together, and as it is holding together in compression, it is acting as a rigid structure, as if a single component, and hence it is able to withstand the high power stroke which have a tendency to push the component away from each other because of the high firing pressure. Because of the tie bolt acting as a rigid structure, the whole component acting as a rigid structure, it is been held in a single component. So let's see what I have written here. The bolt help to withstand the cyclic stress which occur due to firing force. Now what are the maintenance of tie bolt? Time to time we need to check the hydraulic tightening of the tie bolt. 24 month routine of hydraulic tightness check is carried out. As you can see, as it is subjected to cyclic stress, the hydraulic tightening bolt, means as it is tightened, so it need to be checked whether it is correctly tightened to up to correct pressure or not. If it is not, in that case we have to re-tighten it, because of the cyclic stress it may get loosened up. Now let's see what is fitting. So fitting is a mechanism where referred to wear and sometime corrosion and damage at the asperities of the contact surface. This damage is induced under load and in presence of repetitive relative surface motion as induced, example by vibration and cyclic stress. So what do I mean by that? As you can see, these two components, which each individual component is been held apart from tie bolt by the fitted bolt. This fitted bolt is provided here holding these two components, and the tie bolt is holding all the three components. Now means continuous cyclic stress is occurring because of continuous cycle of exhaust, scavenging, power stroke, compression. Okay, so over a period of time it may happen that the these two structure may get loosened up, or if the tie bolt is loose, means is loosened up, in that case what will happen, these two surface will undergo a vibration, means it is having a vibration, small vibration, which is causing the rubbing surface, means having a like this effect. Okay, continuously it has been moving in this phase manner, causing the removal of the metal. Means as you can see here in this diagram, this type of asperities wear will occur because of continuous moving of two surfaces like this together. Okay, now same thing I have written here. The damage induced under load and in the presence of repetitive relative surface motion means the surface motion is repetitive in nature and it is removing the asperities or metal present around the surface. Now By regular inspection of hydraulic tightness of tie bolt and looking area near tie bolt for any reddish color oxidation accumulation which occur due to fretting and corrosion. Basically what happened, a corrosion or a wear near the area can be seen and can be inspected. If a reddish formation may occur sometime because of the metal, this metal is worn out and will accumulate on that area. Okay, I will show you in my next slide. So as you can see, this is a tie bolt. Okay, this is a hydraulic nut. Now because this tie bolt is loosened up, these two will continuous rub against each other, and because of repetitive relative motion, a wear will occur which will cause a brown or reddish powder formation here. In the top view you will see this is a tie bolt, this is a hydraulic nut. So around the surface you will see metal powder will form due to fretting, which will get oxidized and form a brown color formation near bolt. This indicates loose tie bolt and the tie bolt need inspection. So during taking a round, we should also check around the tie bolt, there should not be any brown color formation or reddish color formation. Metal wear should not be there. If it is there, it means that the tie bolt is loosened up and the fitting is taking place. We need to inspect instantaneously and we need to check that the hydraulic nut is tightened properly or not. I hope you like the video. Please do like and subscribe. And I am going to upload the part 2 of the tie bolt, where I will discuss about the tie bolt tightness and tie bolt position, and part 3. The whole tie bolt will be described in a 3 part. So please remain tuned and please subscribe and share. Image credit goes to marinediesel.co.in.